Westphalian products go to Herr Hoyt.
Charles, you and Williams serve as vanguard. Let no man reach us.
What about me?
You and John will follow from a distance and keep watch over us. I'll signal you when I have need of your services.
By royal charter, King's College has been created in...
We're here to help you, along with those held inside Southgate Fort.
Free me.
Not until we're inside the gate. I can't chance an inspection of the gate going wrong. I'll see you safe. You have my word.
With the Mohawk has been promised. For all manner of...
Do you know anything of Silas' operation? How many men we might expect? The nature of their defenses? You must be rather important to him if you are given your own escort.
Sir, the enemies are hit. Shall I engage them?
No. Let Jonathan and Thomas take care of it.
As you wish.
I wish you'd trust us. Though I suppose it's only natural for you to be wary. So be it. Engage the enemy!
Only say the word, and I'll cut them down.
Who's your officer?
Engage the enemy!
Looks like you're to meet the Reaper.
All clear! Evening, gentlemen.
State your business.
Delivery for Silas.
Go on, then.
See? I'm freeing you just as I said I would. Now, if you'll allow me to explain. Let her go.
But she'll give us away.
No, she won't.
What's the plan?
Free the captives and avoid detection.
What of Silas?
He dies.
I know when you're ready to strike.
To patrol with us.
So said Silas. I assume it's all rather straightforward.
Oi, fellas. Apologies for me tardiness. Cutter had me working late.
You know Cutter?
Well, who do you think got me this post? We're like brothers, me and him. Now, what's it Silas want us doing? We're to rough up the prisoners?
Relieve them of their finery? Aye.
An hour of quiet was all I asked. Instead, I'm awakened not 10 minutes later by this cacophonous madness. I expect an explanation, and it had best be good. How? How did this happen? My precious merchandise set free! It's unacceptable! Rest assured, I'll have the heads of those responsible. But first we clean up this mess. Seal the fort, kill any who try to escape. I don't care if they be one of us or one of them. To approach the gate is to be made a corpse. Am I understood?
Push them back.
Go on here. We'll hold back the guards while you deal with Silas.
For the order! For the
the interloper!
Benjamin!
He's the one responsible!
Glad to have you with us. I could use some help.
I'll fillet you like a cod.
Who are you?
Name's Haytham Kenway. You don't know me, but I believe the two of you are well acquainted.
I made a promise to you, Cyrus. One I intend to keep.
What happens now?
We wait. And not for very long, I suspect. It's been several weeks now since we freed the Mohawk prisoners from captivity. I had hoped their leader might make contact, but there's been only silence. My men grow restless. They want to know what comes next, and I do not have an answer. Lee alone remains active, pursuing leads, however slight. He stalks the city streets and scouts the bordering woods, hopeful that he might make contact with one of those we saved. There was a woman there that night. It was she who helped the others to safety. If we can find her, I believe I'll have my answers. So, I watch and wait, hopeful that my true mission might finally begin. Hello, Charles. Any luck finding our mystery woman?
Word is she's been stirring up trouble just outside the city in a town called Lexington.
Well, then that's where we begin our search. I'll meet you there.
Porter's light water craft.
For cheerful diversion at all times of year, contract the music.
Come on.
Infantry there.
Thank you. the finest, daintiest sleeve ruffles this side of town.
recruiting Indian allies to the cause of the Crown. The Indians continue to ally with the
British.
Have you found her?
She's made camp not too far from here.
Excellent. Well, the sooner we're done, the sooner we can get out of this cold.
I am afraid I have some bad news, sir.
Oh?
Braddock is insisting I return to service under him. I've tried to beg off, to no avail.
No doubt he's still angry about losing Pitcairn. To say nothing of the shaming we gave him. Do as he asks. In the meantime, I'll work on having you released.
I'm sorry for the trouble.
Not your fault.
We're too late.
Fire's only just been snuffed. Snow recently disturbed. She's close.
Bollocks.
These tracks are fresh. They must be hers. Seems she took to higher ground. Out of the snow and into the trees. Return to Braddock, Charles, before he grows suspicious. I can handle things from here.
But, sir!
But nothing! Go! Stop running! I only wish to talk! I am not your enemy! Please just hear me out! Gods, woman! Only let me speak! Enough with these games! Try my patience, woman!
Touched in the head?
me, Haytham. I come in peace.
Why are you speaking so slow?
Sorry.
What do you want?
Well, your name, for one.
I'm Gadzidzio.
Pleased to meet you. Gadzidzio.
Just call me Zio.
Dio.
Zio.
Dio.
Now tell me why it is you're here. Where did you get this?
From an old friend.
I've only seen such markings in one other place.
Where?
Well, it is forbidden for me to speak of it.
I saved your people. Does this mean nothing to you? Look, I am not the enemy.
Close to here, there is a hill. Meet me there, and we'll see if you speak the truth. That town hosts soldiers who seek to drive my people from these lands. They're led by a man known as the Bulldog.
Edward Braddock.
You know him?
He is no friend of mine.
Every day, more of my people are lost to men like him.
Then I suggest we put a stop to it. Together.
What do you propose?
That we kill Edward Braddock. First, we have to find him.
I don't trust you.
I know.
Yet you remain.
That I might prove you wrong.
It will not happen.
So you say.
So I know.
Yet, I remain. Wait here. A Mohawkman is likely to raise suspicions, if not muskets.
This is hardly the first time I've been amongst your people. I can handle myself.
I hope so.
I hear tell the French are readying to move on our positions. Wonder what Braddock intends to do about it.
He's already left for the advance camp. I'll wager our little holiday here is just about ended. We'll be marching south before week's end.
Can't stand being quartered there. The endless crashing of the waves, the sting of the salt in the eyes. And the goddamn gulls shrieking and shitting everywhere.
You're sure that's where we're going?
Aye. The Bulldog's putting together another expedition.
That's what they're calling them now. Expeditions.
Aye. Smart, too. Slap a fancy name on something and all evil is excused.
Oi! Where are you going, Cully?
Me?
No. The other cock, Robin.
Well, I was leaving.
Oh? And now?
Well, now, I'm going to feed you your teeth.
And you were worried I was going to be the problem? You're hurt.
Oh, it's nothing.
Here. This should stop the bleeding.
That wasn't necessary. But thank you.
We should move on. Meet me at Braddock's camp when you're ready. Use the snowstorm to mask your approach. Having second thoughts?
Hardly. But I'll have to approach this carefully.
Go on then. I'll keep watch from here.
I can hide in that cart.
What's in the wagon? I need a full inventory.
As you wish. Let's see. 2 barrels of salt, 12 pounds pork, 10 pounds beef, 7 dozen eggs, 16 wheels of cheese, none of it French, don't worry, 5 bottles of whiskey, a couple of dozen new uniforms, boots, a leather for patching, blankets, a cart feed for the horses. What else? That's it. That's all there is.
Those cannons are like to cause trouble. Perhaps I could sabotage them.
will be no truce.
Damn it!
Why, George? What reason did he give?
He said a diplomatic solution was no solution at all. That allowing the French to retreat would only delay an inevitable conflict, one in which they'd now have the upper hand.
There's merit to those words, as much as I hate to admit it. Still, can't he see this is unwise?
He doesn't fit well. It puts the men at risk. I'd rather not be delivering grim news to mothers and widows because the bulldog wanted to prove a point. Where is the general now?
Those cannons are like to cause trouble. Perhaps I could sabotage them.
Tell me you good news. General Braddock refused the offer. There will be no truce.
Damn it!
Why, George? What reason did he give?
He said a diplomatic solution was no solution at all. That allowing the French to retreat would only delay an inevitable conflict, one in which they'd now have the upper hand.
There's merit to those words, as much as I hate to admit it. Still, can't he see this is unwise?
He doesn't fit well with me either. We're far from home with our forces. I fear Braddock's bloodlust can be carried. It puts them at a risk. I'd rather not be caring for the youth, mothers, and widows because the bulldog wanted to prove a point.
Those cannons are like to cause trouble. Perhaps I could sabotage them.
Said a diplomatic solution was no solution at all. That allowing the French to retreat would only delay an inevitable conflict, one in which they'd now have the upper hand.
There's merit to those words, as much as I hate to admit it.
Still, can't he see this is unwise?
It doesn't fit well with me either. We're far from home with our forces divided. Worse, I fear Braddock's bloodlust makes him careless. It puts the men at risk. I'd rather not be delivering grim news to mothers and widows because the bulldog wanted to prove a point.
Where is the general now?
Rallying the troops.
And then it's on to Fort Duquesne, I assume?
Eventually. The march north will surely take time. There's a copy of the plans in the command tent should you wish to review them.
At least this will be ended soon.
I tried, John.
I know, my friend. I know.
That map will surely be of use. I need to find it. Those cannons are like to cause trouble. Perhaps I could sabotage them.
There's merit to those words, as much as I hate to admit it.
Still, can't he see this is unwise?
He doesn't fit well with me either. We're far from home with our forces divided. Worse, I fear Braddock's bloodlust makes him careless. It puts the men at risk. I'd rather not be delivering grim news to mothers and widows because the Bulldog wanted to prove a point.
Where is the General now?
Rallying the troops.
And then it's on to Fort Duquesne, I assume?
Eventually. The march north will surely take time. There's a copy of the plans in the command tent should you wish. At least this will be ended soon. I try, John.
I know, my friend. I know.
That map will surely be of use. I need to find it. Those cannons are like to cause trouble. Perhaps I could sabotage them. Those cannons are like to cause trouble. Perhaps I could sabotage them. Those cannons are like to cause trouble. Perhaps I could sabotage them. Thank you. Those cannons are like to cause trouble. Perhaps I could sabotage them. Those cannons are like to cause trouble. Perhaps I could sabotage them.
Oh!
What news?
Braddock has left to rally his troops. They're marching on Fort Duquesne. It'll be a while yet till they're ready, which gives us time to form a plan.
No need. We will ambush him here near the river. Go and gather your allies. I will do the same. I will send word when it is time to strike.
In the cold, cold ground.
Here, here.
Hard at work, I see.
How did you...
It is time. We set up camp to the north. Meet me there.
Gentlemen. Let us away.
First it was too cold. Now it's too goddamn hot.
And humid too. It's a right swamp, I tell you.
To say nothing of the mosquitoes.
Warm weather and bugs are soon to be the least of our worries.
What? You mean the bulldog? Please. We'll be in that one's beef soon enough and on to the next.
Where's your boy Lee gone off to?
Returned to finish out his service under Braddock.
I imagine the Bulldog's none too pleased after the stunt we pulled.
Pleased to spin a tale of my incompetence and beg forgiveness. He has a way with words, especially when it comes to flattery. I expect he'll be welcomed back with open arms.
Which would give us a man inside.
Precisely.
Unless you've underestimated our enemy.
If I have, Charles will sense it first and make his escape. He's Mork. I see you've been busy.
All these men are from many different tribes, united in their desire to see Braddock sent away. The Abenaki, the Lenape, the Shawnee.
And you? Who do you stand for?
Myself.
What would you have me do?
Will you help the others to prepare? Follow. They come.
Everything all right, sir?
Just savoring the moment. No doubt. Many wonder why it is we've pushed so far west. These are wild lands, as yet untamed and unsettled. But it shall not always be so. In time, our holdings will no longer suffice. And that day is closer than you think. We must ensure our people have ample room to grow and further prosper. Which means we need more land. The French understand this. And endeavor to prevent such growth. They skirt around our territory, erecting forts and forging alliances, awaiting the day they might strangle us with the noose they've built. This must not come to pass. We must sever the cord and send them back. This is why we ride, to offer them one last chance. The French will leave, or they will die.
Now's the time to strike.
Wait. To scatter the expedition is not enough. We must ensure that Braddock falls, else he's sure to try again. I'll disguise myself as one of his own and make my way to his side. Your ambush will provide the perfect cover for me to deliver the killing blow.
We await your signal.
There, in front of us.
Thank you.
I'm telling you, we've packed the cart too high.
Have the, you mean?
Sir, you are great.
Edward. Not so fun on the other end of the barrel, is it?
Look out!
Sir. Where are you off to, Edward? I never took you for a coward, Edward.
Come on, then! Such arrogance. I always knew it would be the end of you. Is the end of you.
Don't. Hurry before he gets away! I said go!
I don't deserve this! You're a hypocrite, Atom!
I'm sorry, Edward, but you forced my hand!
Why, Haytham?
Your death opens a door. It's nothing personal. Well, maybe it is a little personal. Been a pain in my ass, after all.
But we are brothers in arms.
Once, perhaps. No longer. Do you think I've forgotten what you did? All those innocents slaughtered, and for what?
It does not engender peace to cut your way to resolution.
Wrong. Whether we applied the sword more liberally and more often, the world would be a better place than it is today.
In this instance, I concur. Farewell, Edward.
Done.
Now I've upheld my part of the bargain. I expect that you will honor yours.
Follow me.
No. No!
You seem disappointed.
I thought that I held a key that would open something here.
This room is all there is.
I expected more. What do they mean?
It tells the story of Yotzitzizu, who came into their world and shaped it for what life might come. She had a hard journey, fraught with great loss and peril. But she believed in her children and what they might achieve. And though she is long gone from the physical world, her eyes still watch over us. Her ears still hear our words. Her hands still guide us. And her love still gives us strength.
You have shown me great kindness, dear. Thank you. I should go.
Master Kenway, did you find it then?
It was not the right place.
The others are waiting for you.
Gentlemen, please sit. I fear our temple was no more than a painted cave. Although it did contain precursor images and script, which means we are close.
Not close enough, it seems.
We need to redouble our efforts and expand our order. and establish a permanent base here. Although the site eludes us, I am confident we will find it.
Truth.
Hear, hear.
Furthermore, I believe it is time we welcome Charles into our fold. He has proven himself a loyal disciple and served unerringly since the day he came to us. He should be able to share in our knowledge and reap all the benefits that such a gift implies. Are any opposed? Very well. Charles, come, stand. Do you swear to uphold the principles of our order and all that for which we stand?
I do.
And never to share our secrets nor divulge the true nature of our work?
I do.
And to do so from now until death, whatever the cost?
I do.
Then we welcome you into our fold, brother. Together, we will usher in the dawn of a new world, one defined by purpose and order. Give me your hand. You are a Templar. May the Father of Understanding guide us.
May the Father of Understanding guide us.
Wait, what? You all saw that, right?
Wow.
Well, indeed.
The key must be the amulet Haytham took from London.
We might know what it looks like, but we're no closer to finding it. Desmond, you need to keep going.
Hey, he's your ancestor, too. Why don't you hop in the Animus?
Really? That's your response? It's like dealing with a 6-year-old. What is wrong with you, Desmond?
You want to know what's wrong? I'm sick of being treated like I'm not even here. Desmond, do this. Desmond, do that. Desmond, you better figure things out because the sun is going to turn us all to ash. And I know I was really nice to you, but actually I'm just another Templar plot twist. And yes, I would like very much for you to be controlled by a magic space wizard so that you can murder me. So there's your answer. I'm sick of being a goddamn pawn. I thought it might be different with you. I mean, you're my father, but it turns out you're no better than the fucking Templars.
Don't you ever equate me to those bastards again. You hear me? Everything I do, everything I have done, has been for you. Maybe I pushed a little too hard, asked a little too much, but try and remember exactly what's at stake here. You need to get it together, kid. Running out of
right.
time.
That was unusual. Well, I'm just going to pretend that this never happened and get back to bringing everyone up to speed on where we stand. The news isn't good. It appears this temple is powered by a collection of, well, I guess they're batteries. You found one on your way in, but there aren't any more, at least not down here.
Any idea on where we can find replacements?
Not yet, so I intend to tiptoe into the Abstergo database. Now, if I can cross-reference these particular devices with their database, then maybe we'll get lucky.
See what you can do.
Obviously. Anyway, Desmond, you can either take a look around here or we can head back to the Animus.